Thank you. Okay. Okay. Thanks, everyone. I'm from IBM China Research Lab. And meanwhile, I'm the leader of the SuperVessel Cloud. Last week, SuperVessel has passed its 500 days. SuperVessel, when we launched it in 2014, actually we aimed to create an OpenPOWER free cloud to demonstrate that using the OpenPOWER system and architecture, we can achieve the same advantage and even the more advanced than the, those things on x86. And after more than 1 year's work, we actually contribute back more than 2,000 commits into back into the OpenStack Summit, more than 2,000 commits in the K version, L version, and also the common M version. So that means really using the OpenPOWER, we can create a more advanced cloud infrastructure. And in last year, end of last year, because of the cognitive computing, we redirect the SuperVessel's direction into more focus on the cognitive computing because we want to further the demonstrate that using OpenPOWER architecture with better the SMT, with better the interface connected with GPU and FPGA, you can build the better the cognitive computing system. So this is the topic about this presentation. Because this morning, the CEO of NVIDIA already spent a lot of time to talk about the cognitive computing, the deep learning, those kind of things. I don't want to spend the time here, but I just want to emphasize that the cognitive computing really will bring the new opportunity for the infrastructure and really can bring the real the new opportunity for the cloud infrastructure. But the challenge is, how can we manage those heterogeneous computing things? For example, the GPU and FPGA in the cloud and certify both the deep learning, the training, and also the online application deployment. How can we better manage them is the challenge. So, actually last year, I'm here to tell about to talk about the SuperVessel, just to remind you that SuperVessel actually built on top of the OpenPOWER architecture. We used the OpenStack to build it, and also to support a lot of KVM, Docker, Spark, all those kind of open source things. And the workload we focus is today is cognitive computing, big data, cloud data service, the Internet of Things, and also the x86 to power porting service. For this last one, the x86 to power porting, we researched together with our product team, we developed a tool called the auto porting. And I will introduce it in the Thursday, the ISV roundtable. That is a very interesting tool to help you to port the x86 to power without the effort. Oh, sorry. Okay, today on SuperVessel, as I mentioned, we have the infrastructure service, including the normal the computer service, accelerator, data, and network. But in the platform layer, we already enable the cognitive computing service besides the other services. So this is our overall architecture. The main difference compared with other public cloud is we have both the GPU and FPGA in the cloud. For our infrastructure service, we support both the GPU and FPGA as the services. That's the main difference. Of course, we also have the power server, open power server, and we can also support the x86 server. We manage all these kind of things using the same set of OpenStack. And the other thing is I want to highlight is that we support both the KVM and Docker as the service. Actually, SuperVessel, we have more than 30 the countries users and support more than 50 the universities. But most of the instances in SuperVessel today is Docker. Okay, back to the cognitive computing. We believe that if we look at the cognitive computing, the left-hand side is the training part. And it will be very suitable to use the CPU plus GPU. On the right-hand side, it is the inference part or so-called deployment or recognition part, it will need to support massive requests for the application. And it will be more suitable to with the CPU and FPGA because FPGA can give you the more power efficiency and more real-time performance. So the question is, we need to support the GPU and FPGA in the cloud infrastructure if we want to support the connected computing cloud. So that's why in SuperVessel 2.0 today, to support the connected computing, we enable the GPU and FPGA in the infrastructure layer. Today, if you go to that link, you will get all these kind of things on SuperVessel for free. It is the cognitive computing stuff. We provide the three layers. One is the first is the cognitive infrastructure service. It is an as service, infrastructure as service, providing the compute, FPGA, and GPU as service. The second is the cognitive computing service. We provide the deep learning, such as the CAFE, Siano, TensorFlow, those kind of things, and big data, media processing, and the other processing. And the last one is a lot of demo and solution service on my right-hand side. So you can try the different cognitive computing solution and demo, which already ready on the OpenPOWER cloud on SuperVessel. And most of them actually already accelerated by GPU or FPGA. Here is the GPU. First, let me talk about the GPU. We SuperVessel provide the GPU service. And the user, they could apply the Docker instances on SuperVessel. This is also the unique things we provide on this OpenPOWER cloud. Yeah, the first one to provide the GPU sharing service in the container cloud in the world. So you can go to the dashboard to apply for free. On the right-hand side is the user can also apply the deep learning development framework on SuperVessel. We today provide the four different framework, CAFE, Torch, Theano, and TensorFlow. All of them are running in the OpenPOWER cloud and also attached with the GPU. That means for the user, you directly go to the SuperVessel cloud to click the button, then in less than 1 minute, you can get the OpenPOWER Docker, which already installed with this, selected the framework, and also accelerated with the GPU already. Okay, then the second thing is the FPGA accelerator service. We developed the FPGA virtualization technology for three years. So today on SuperVessel, the user, you can apply the KVM or Docker with the virtualized FPGA accelerator. That means actually in this infrastructure, single the FPGA card, FPGA chip can be divided into the multiple area, and this multiple area can be shared by multiple the virtual machine or multiple Docker. It can be loaded with different accelerator in same FPGA. It can be managed by the cloud. We extend the OpenStack to manage all these kind of things. So the user, they can go to our accelerator maker zone to upload their code so that we can support. Thank you. Much better. Thank you. So the user, you can upload your code and then use this OpenPOWER cloud to do the compilation. Then the cloud will help you to do the automatic deployment into the FPGA and attach to the or KVM. Yeah. And this is something that we did this year, really new. We will launch it in this Friday together with Silence. It is called the Accelerator DevOps. DevOps is very key term in the cloud. That means the development and operation service. And we developed this Accelerator DevOps on the cloud. What's mean? That means for the FPGA developer, you can do the project management, you can do the coding using the SDSL, which support the OpenCL. You can do the coding on the cloud, and you can do the compilation on the cloud. And finally, you can provision your accelerator bit file into this cloud onto the PowerPlus Capit interface. Yeah, all of these kind of things can be finished on the cloud. It is ready, and we will launch it by the end of this week. Yeah, we will talk about more in the coming CAPI workshop on Friday. Okay, this is another interesting thing I want to share. Just now I mentioned for the cognitive computing, we will have the training part, training stage, which will be very suitable for GPU plus CPU. But on the application deployment part, which you will also have the classification, inference, it will be very suitable to CPU plus FPGA. Problem is, for most of our deep learning scientists today, they don't know how to program the FPGA. They don't know anything about the VHDL or Verilog. So our research team, we developed a tool called the ACCDNN, Accelerator DNN. It's helped to automatically convert the trained model into the FPGA code, then to do the compilation, then you will get the bit file. That means if you use the CAFE to develop your deep learning model, once this model has been trained, then you just get the model file and the input into this tool, then this tool can help you to automatically generate the FPGA code bit file. The second important thing is because we have the underlying libraries using the RTL level language to do the implementation, so we can guarantee the performance is very good. So here I list the performance after the first version. This performance is based on the automatic generate code. And it can get the 23 times advantage, performance advantage comparing with CPU. More than 20 times better than CPU. And actually, I also have the compare with the GPU K40, but I cannot list here because this is the GPU conference. If you have interest, you can ask me off. Okay, this is the last slide. Using SuperVessel today, we can demonstrate that cognitive computing platform can be available on OpenPOWER. It is free for all the user in the world, free for all the developer, and free for all the student. But you cannot do the commercial activity on SuperVessel. It is built by IBM Research. And using SuperVessel, we can demonstrate that OpenPOWER architecture has the advantage for the cognitive computing. Because the first thing is the SMT capability. I mentioned just now, to support the cognitive computing, actually, more than half of our computing instance is on Docker. So in another talk tomorrow, we have a presentation about the container cloud on OpenPOWER. It is in the same time tomorrow, lunchtime. The second is because this CAPI and NVIDIA, so it will provide you the high performance optimized accelerator interface, which is very important for the cognitive computing. And the third one is easy for programming with the CAPI. So please try SuperVessel with all this cognitive computing technology and services. And this is our URL, and this is our code for the WeChat. Okay, thanks.